a mother from the older brother of your children made three. Now you found your lover, cause it wasn't our father who made you laugh and happy. It's been a long 5 years. What's your name?
Mykel Harris.
How old are you?
23.
What are you doing nowadays?
No, I just moved back from Georgia. In the process of applying to physical therapy school.
How's that going?
It's going well. You know, I've been observing that Wake Med. So I had the opportunity to shadow some, meet some new people, you know, some people with some interesting stories, and it's been pretty a good experience.
So this whole concept is talking to a younger or older version of yourself. Which one are you choosing to talk to?
I just want to talk to my future self.
Talk to your future self? Mm-hmm. What are you saying to the future, Mykel Harris?
Everything that you went through, you know, it happened for a reason, and use it to make it a better you. You know what I'm saying? You know, when I think about my life, that all the sacrifices that people have made for me and my family, my brother, you know what I'm saying? It hasn't always been the easiest of times, but you know, like I said, it kind of gives me this motivation, this drive to keep on pushing forth and be the best person I can be, because, you know, I don't want the sacrifices that the people that, you know, the people that done things for me to go to waste, you know. No, when I think about my life, first off, if I had to bring it back, you know, straight from the beginning, I kind of grew up in a dysfunctional home. Mom and dad got divorced when I was in middle school, and basically grew up with a single mom, and a dad that wasn't present in my life. You know, mom lost her job. Mom lost her job when we was in middle school, and like I said, she sacrificed everything she had to make sure that we had the life that she wanted us to have. And when I grew up, and I think back, you know what I'm saying? I had a great childhood. But as an adult looking back, you know, I look back and I say, like, wow, like, my mom went through a lot just for us, you know what I'm saying? And I remember, you know, coming home from school, you know what I'm saying? Nothing in the refrigerator, you know what I'm saying? And my mom always made sure that, you know, we had something to eat, regardless of if she ate or not, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, she always made sure that we were in the best position to be ourselves, in the best position to thrive and succeed, you know. I remember my mom always telling me that we had a purpose, and that everything we was going through, you know what I'm saying, use it as fuel to be the best person you can be and do the things that you were meant to be, that God meant you to be. When I think back, you know, the time when we moved to North Carolina, and, you know, that was a struggle in itself, because, you know, we easily could have been homeless. We basically moved off faith. My mom didn't have no job coming into North Carolina. She didn't have no type of income. We didn't have no house. We literally just packed up our stuff and we just moved here, and like I said, it's nothing but the grace of God. You know, we found some type of house to live in. But even then, when we had a house, my mom didn't have no job. So that was very stressful. It's positive. No. Like I said, you know, my mother sacrificed so much for us, you know, me and my brother You know, and at the time I had no idea of what she was doing. You know, as a teenager, you don't necessarily see past the cloudiness of life, but I didn't trust that my mom had her best interest, you know what I'm saying? Because I had I was in a toxic relationship in Georgia, you know, where I had my first love, you know, and I was sprung over her, boy. But I was basically, you know, didn't want to leave her to start a whole new life elsewhere, and the idea of change scared me. The idea, because I was living in Georgia for a long period of time, at this point, close to 10 years, and I basically grew up there. And the idea of moving to a completely new spot, changing friends, meeting new people, being a whole different environment, scared me. And, you know, I just thank God that, you know, that this happened, because like the sacrifices that my mom made is just, now you found your lover, cause it wasn't our father who made it just laugh and happy. It's been a long 5 years. I'm just thankful for the opportunities that has been put in front of me. Now the skies are clear, and now there's no more slamming doors. Now I say, dear mother, I'm having a hard time like this.
It's alright, just let it go. Let it flow, bro. I'ma edit this out. Just let it flow. You wanna turn it off?
Yeah, I don't wanna do it.
You sure?
I probably don't know. I hope your proud mother will what you've done. It's a lifelong lesson, and I'm not pretending when I say you cleared up my scars. You cleared up my scars.